Welcome everybody. A weird introduction to this awesome, lovely, doubly adventure time, dork time, streaming extravaganza. I'm gonna call it
everybody.
That. I'm gonna call it that.
A weird introduction.
Oh no, you can hear us twice. Oh no, you can hear us three times. That's how good we are today. Welcome, welcome, welcome everybody. This is Dork Time, and we are here to talk about the greatest cartoon episode that is making us happy right now. That is Dork Time. Mm-hmm. I am Colored, and I am here with my awesome lady friend, Wildberry.
Hello.
And we've been doing a lot of episodes, and today is going to be a very specific one. It's about season 4, Tops and Bottoms. And I think this is going to be an interesting one because for me, in my opinion, there are a lot of good ones.
I had an extremely difficult time finding bottoms.
Yes, yes.
I got kind of just like, if I felt, it kind of had to be like, well, this one, like, it's still good, but it's not like as good. That was kind of the criteria.
There's like maybe like 20 episodes that are like good.
Yeah.
And then like the 6 are like the best, and then you kind of have to go to the bottom of the 20 that you like.
I could have done 6 tops. Easy.
I was going to say we probably should have done 5, but I like the 3 because it kind of makes me nervous. Like, am I picking the right 3?
It makes me really, really think about what it is and like why it is I'm picking this one. Like, I have to get specific. Like, what is going to be my criteria and stuff. So like, I do like the 3 because it's, you know, if we let it get bigger, then you can basically go, well, I like all of them. Like,
right.
So I think it forces you to really think about the episodes.
That's true. And one of the cool things is that like, once you pick them, you feel good. Like, okay, I did it.
Yeah, I got it.
I got it. It's all good. Well, how you been?
I've been good. Today was a pretty cool day because my sister is back from college for a week.
Nice.
She's on her spring break, so we have a full house again. She came for lunch with us. She got us. She brought me and my mom. We work together, and we only take a half an hour lunch break. And so it's really hard to like go pick something up and still have time to eat.
Yep.
So my sister actually got us In-N-Out, which is the best. And
no idea
like,
what that is.
It's I mean, you know the concept of In-N-Out, right?
I guess it's a fast food restaurant, right?
Oh my god. Yeah. It's
that's all I know.
It's just like a, what is it? You know how like White Castle is the East Coast, like everybody wants to get a White Castle burger or something.
Sure. Yeah.
It's kind of like that. Like, it's a fast food burger. It's very simple. Like, they, I mean, it's like $5 for a meal for like a cheeseburger, fries, and a Coke. $5.
Nice.
And they are, it's all like they pay their workers really well. The food is really like high quality. One of the reasons they don't have it open everywhere, it's only in California and like Arizona, is because they will only open a franchise like where you can ship within a day from the factory.
Oh, interesting.
So, like, all their ingredients are fresh. It's really, really good, I think. But it is still a fast food burger, so don't let me sell it as, like, some gourmet thing.
No.
You
can't gourmet fast food.
Yeah. It's a fast food burger. It's just delicious. It's, like, my favorite thing. So, Claire, my sister, she brought it, and we had lunch together, and we, like, ate outside on a bench and stuff. It was really nice.
Nice.
Yeah.
This has probably been the most busiest, hobbyist week I've ever had. Like,
why is it?
Like, I do a lot of hobbies. I didn't realize it until this week. Like, I do a lot of fun things like this. I do another podcast with my friends for the baseball podcast. And then, like, I also had to play D&D this week. And we went with the people that I do the podcast with. We watched baseball. We watched the World Baseball Classic, which is on Monday and Wednesday. The D&D was on Tuesday. Thursday was me editing their stuff, like the audio for the podcast. Friday was the actual podcast for the next one, and today is Dork time.
Wow. Busy man.
I never thought I'd be like, I'm not trying to be cool or anything. I was just trying to say, like, I like, you kind of take back and you're like, holy shit, I didn't get to do anything. I didn't even get to watch The Flash this week.
Look at that.
So so it's but I've been drinking more because I've been outside socially, you know, which is not a good thing.
I think that's like, it's so hard. It's like I end up drinking all the time when I'm social, or, you know, and I try, I want to not do that. I want to,
the good thing is that, like, I feel like I found myself not getting, like, wasted, like blackout wasted, or like drinking shots like crazy like I used to. Maybe my old self is telling me nope.
And we're getting older.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah.
So, like, I like to sit back and talk and now have a beer or, like, have a cocktail or whatever, right?
Yeah, that's, yeah. That's my preferred method.
Or if I have a shooter, I won't, like, chug it. Like, I'll just, like, sip it. Like, if it's, like, I don't know, like, a whiskey or something, you know?
Right.
Yeah, it was pretty interesting to, like, kind of find myself, like, being on a schedule. But also, I felt bad for my dog because I barely seen my dog this whole week. And Ava has been, my lady has been very busy herself because she has a few part-time jobs. So, like, so we've been, like, in and out. And today, hopefully, after this podcast, we'll, like, have a date, a day to go on a date. Yeah.
Aw, that'll be good.
Yeah.
Well, we can, yeah.
Yeah, I think so, too.
Busy lives. Busy lives we lead. Well, let's actually start
and I
get
think so.
Into this.
Yes, people. Here we're going to be talking about awesome stuff, about our tops and bottoms, and it was very hard to pick, in my opinion.
Yeah.
But I think we're going to start with the bottoms first.
All right.
And you're going to lead it off and tell us what is the bottom number three.
I'm going to want you to pull up the picture because I got so confused with
my
notes.
It's all good. Here we go. Ready? Boom.
See, this is how you can tell. Okay. You can tell that I had a hard time because I, like, I'm looking at it and I'm like, I can't remember. Okay, so King Worm was my bottom three pick. I mean, I still enjoyed this episode. It's trippy. It's really trippy. The King Worm is a dick.
Yeah.
But I also, like, don't get what he wants.
Right.
Not really. Like, I mean, he wants the brain energy and, like, I don't know. This is a kind of random one that I don't think we've seen again. Like, we haven't, like, explored this further.
I don't think
so. So I kind of put it on there just because I was like, well, I mean, it's, like, it's cool. It's totally worth watching, but you could skip it and not really miss anything.
I agree. I mean, it's just, it's definitely one of those trippy one episode a season kind of thing.
Yeah.
And it was pretty, I don't know. I agree. It was at the bottom of my likes.
Mm.
But I just love how trippy it was. Like, I just couldn't deal with it. Like, I loved it so much because of that. But again, I understand.
Yeah, again, it was like I'm just struggling to pick something where I'm like, okay, like, how often would I put on King Worm? It's not one of the ones where I like to analyze. I mean, it's ripe for analysis, I guess. Like, what does this mean? But it's not one of my, like I don't know. I don't feel like it's, like, super important. But again, it's a good episode. Don't not watch this episode.
No, I agree. There are many things you can take out of this episode. One, you can take drugs and watch the episode.
Yes.
Or, you know what? Now that I was thinking about it, maybe we should have a full episode of just, like, episodes you should watch when you're tripping.
That's a great idea.
Cheers
to that.
I think
I agree. Like, because this is just trippy.
Mm-hmm. All right. Now, this is a good one. I know it's a bottom. I know I'm saying good, but it's only our bottom because it's something we have to pick. We have to pick. We have to pick.
I think that says something about this season.
Yeah. All right. Here's the next pick.
Okay, so my bottom two is In Your Footsteps. This is the one where the bear is impersonating Finn, and it gets the Enchiridion, and then eventually we find out that he was working for the Lich. I mean, I kind of just don't like the bear. Even if he wasn't working for the Lich, like, I just... even when I thought he was just like a socially awkward bear, I didn't feel that bad for the bear.
Oh, I did. I did. And this is, when he was doing this shit, I was like, this guy has issues. And
so see, like, I was more like, this is creepy, and Finn is being a jerk by not listening to Jake. But Jake's telling him, dude, this is not okay.
No, it's not okay.
And Finn doesn't listen. Like, because, I mean, like, yeah, you could help him, but don't, like, don't encourage the creepy behavior.
That is true. That's definitely true.
Like, I guess in this one, I didn't like it because of Finn and Jake's, like, dynamic in this one. And they never really resolved it. So, I mean, the bear just got the Enchiridion and gave it to the Lich. I do like it because, I mean, that is part of the key story, and I like how it came out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Big spoilers on that, but we've already reviewed it, so
no spoiler warning for you guys. That's if we go beyond season four, but like for me, one of the greatest parts, and I think we talked about it in length before, was when, you know, when the bear was just like destroying Finn cakes, and like he recorded it, and like he's just like, he's so happy like he caught him, and then Finn's like, what the fuck, man, like you saw this happen and you didn't stop it. And then Jake is like, wait, what did I do wrong?
I do like, though, that Jake was right, because Finn's first instinct was, Jake, you ate all of my Finn cakes when I told you not to.
Right.
So Jake's like, Jake had thought that far ahead, where it's like, look, you can't blame me, because I have proof. And then he didn't think the one step further of like, well, yeah, I did just watch the bear eat all of your Finn cakes. Like...
Oh, Jake.
Funny. Again, I don't think this is a bad episode. Like, I would put it on.
No, I agree. And the stinger at the end was awesome.
Yeah.
That's another reason why I couldn't put it at the bottom.
Yeah.
All right. You ready for your top numero uno?
Mm.
All right. Here we go.
My bottom number one is Web Weirdos. And this was... easier to pick because I just don't like spiders.
No, I know.
I just don't like spiders, and my criteria for bottoms was just not rigorous.
No, I don't blame you. Yeah.
I tried really hard, but I looked at all of them. I read all the synopsis. I read like everything on the wiki, and I was just like, I like most of these episodes, all of these episodes, and I just got picky and was like, okay. I'm curious to see what you did.
Okay, I'll let you know what I did. I picked it in just the basis of like I don't think I didn't like any episodes.
Mm-hmm.
I think I would watch them not as much as others, and like as a replay. So like for me, I actually really like this episode because I like the idea of Finn giving advice and like him maturing, like we talked about.
Relationship advice.
Yeah. But I understand if you didn't like the spider thing. I actually really liked it, to be honest. But
even creepier than normal spiders. Like you'd think, because they don't look exactly like spiders, but they're like, they are still pretty creepy.
Yeah, and especially when this shit happened. Yeah. When they're just like, she's freaking out. He's like, what happened? And then she just squirts out all these goddamn babies. I'm like, oh, crap. I mean, that kind of took it down one. But still, overall, I like everything in the beginning. Definitely.
So gross.
All right.
I want to see yours.
All right. So, my bottom... bottom number three is Goliad. I really liked this episode a lot because it was a really cool... Because this is another thing, too, about Princess Bubblegum, that she makes all these different experiments. There's a lot of different experiments episodes, too. Ooh, we could do that as an episode, too. And this one, like, I got it, and I thought it was interesting, but I don't think it was that funny. So I had to... when I watched it, I had to find the funniest part to me.
Yeah.
Which is this part. But like overall, like
it's a very serious episode. Yeah. It actually is like it's talking about leadership and government and like actually like how do you lead people and what kind of, it's actually really serious and
no it
and
is
you
it definitely
can
is
see the you know like Goliath becomes straight up evil.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah, no,
just,
I think you're right. It's not a funny episode.
No, and it's just one of those like kind of artificial intelligence kind of situations where you build something and you try to make it good, but then it just logically finds out that whatever's going on is bad, no matter what.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
what really ticked me off the most, and I guess it's funny, but it's when they went to the daycare and these kids were going fucking nuts. I was like, no, no. It just reminded me when we were at fucking Ice Bunch. It was just like...
Oh, my God.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I'm talking about.
I do. I do.
That happened to me, kind of, when a kid gave me the middle finger and told me to fuck and said to me, fuck you, and nothing happened to me. Like, nothing that the co-teachers, the school did anything to punish this boy. And I, anyways, oof. Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
No, I agree. That's like a part where it just makes your blood boil because you're like, no, no, I experienced this. I have lived this.
Yeah.
It hits a soft spot right. in your heart where you're just like, no, I can't handle it.
Right. Yeah. All right. Bottom number two, and you might know why.
All right.
So bottom number two is Dream of Love. Like I.
You weren't that fond of it.
No, I think that too. But like, I think I mentioned to you this before that, like, you know, Chi Trunks. She's a character that I don't want as a full episode for. Like, one of those CD characters that like I like in the background for like a few seconds, and I'll be fine. But like, yeah, I can't. I just can't.
Yeah.
I don't know why. She's just like, it just, she's just a hornball. Like, she's a straight up hornball. and then nothing wrong with that. It's just like, it's nothing that I was uncomfortable with. It's just like, I just didn't care for the story. You know? The song was cute. I do have to admit that the song was cute.
I think the song is redeeming, but I also think the fact that, like, at first, Finn and Jake are really, like, upset by the PDA. And then at the end, they're like, you know what? It's kind of nice. Like, they come to understand, like, that, like, oh, you know what? It's love. And, like, it makes me a little uncomfortable. But, like, they're figuring out their love. I don't know. There's something cute about that and to me. But I do remember when we reviewed this. Tree Trunks is a hard one, I think, to have the main focus on because, like, she is kind of like a sexy or sexual grandmother-esque character, which can be very disturbing.
Yes. But I mean, I like the idea of this episode, and I mean, this is probably like at the bottom of the barrel kind of episode I put in the background kind of thing, but. I just didn't really care for this episode. I'm going to be very honest. Yes. I'm going to be very, very honest about that. All right. My bottom numero uno. And that is the Hardys. I did not give a shit about this episode. I did not give a shit. I don't know why. I just did not care for it.
I think they're so cute.
They're cute. I just...
Rants.
Okay, I'm gonna let it out. It's like, this is one episode I did not like. They're cute, but that's it. I love where they are, and I like their story, and it was cute about the whole, you know, the big frog, like they think they're trying to destroy things, but I didn't care for it. I don't know why. I don't think it was that funny too. I mean, the only funny part was the picture that I put when Finn started running up Jake's ass just to kiss him.
Yeah.
You know, that's probably like the funniest part for me. And then like,
that's funny.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, and I know that like Finn kind of thinks about things. We talked about this a little bit. Like he thinks about it, and like it's just random. He just gives us a relapse of what happened with the episode.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I don't know
how he figured it out. I have to say, I'm really happy that we didn't pick any of the same ones for this.
No, we didn't. We didn't.
I'm really happy. Like, most of the time I feel like we agree.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like we agree most of the time on this stuff. But I feel like with this, with liking so many of the episodes, none of them were like a clear, I hate this episode.
Mm.
Not like Donnie or the Duke or something like that.
I still can't believe they still come up.
Very clear. Like, But, like, I'm glad that we, you know, had some difference of opinions. Because, like, I could see why you don't like the episodes you don't like. Even though I don't feel, like, I wouldn't have picked them first.
Yeah. No, no. I mean, that's the thing, too. Like, there's so many episodes, too, like, we could pick. And
yeah.
This is probably one that I wouldn't replay at all. Out of all of them.
Yeah. I really like this one. That's so funny.
Fair enough. All right. So, you ready for the tops?
Yeah.
All right. Top number three. And I hope I got this right.
I think so.
Okay. And that
Fimo.
Is. Yes.
Fimo. Fimo Noir. Okay. So I kind of went. I'll tell you my criteria on these ones. I kind of went for like my. The ones that are like not feel good, but to me, when I watch them, they make me feel like warm and fuzzy and happy. And like I would put them on. Like any time.
Okay.
And they also, except for my number one, they all make me laugh.
Mm-hmm.
This one, Bimo's like my favorite character. It's Bimo centric, and I feel like it totally works. I love like the playing pretend with the animals and like Lorraine and him dating. Lorraine's the chicken, and like just the things that Bimo does and says, like, she's red hot like pizza supper. It's like, what does that mean, Bimo? Like,
so. I don't know. I have no idea. But yeah, no, I agree. This is a good episode. I remember being worried about this episode before we did, this dark time. But I watched it again when we were reviewing it. And I just surprisingly enjoyed it so much more, like tenfold. Like I really enjoyed it. Yeah, I did. I think I talked about it when we streamed it, but like I did enjoy it. It's super fast paced, a lot faster than others.
Yeah.
Especially being like a noir, because noir is kind of like this, black and white, gritty, slow pace, trying to solve something. But this is just like. Just jokes after and puns. I'm pretty sure they had puns too, and it was just like it was a fun episode.
It's So this is one I actually think of this episode. Like I seek it out. I'm like, you know what I want to watch today? Bimo Noir. So that was kind of my prerequisite for my top three was do I ever think about that specific episode? Not when I'm like browsing, but like I go, you know what I want to watch today? This one.
No, that's a good understanding. No, I completely understand you. It's a good one though. Yeah. Definitely a good one.
So funny.
All right. So you want to tell people number two, your top number two?
Yeah, my top number two. Sorry, I was getting a phone call, so I had to stop that. My top number two is Card Wars.
Ooh, Card Wars.
Okay. I love everything about this episode because, like, it's Finn and Jake's relationship. You see a bit more of Jake going a little crazy. I like that Finn,
he's
like,
cray-cray.
Without even. Yeah, he goes crazy. He's obsessed. I like that Finn, like, kicks ass at the game with a pig, like, and like he's so upset about it, like Jake's so upset about it, and it's just, and then at the end what I do like is that Finn kind of like handles the situation, like Bimo's like I won't play with him anymore and Lady won't play with him anymore, but Finn is like nah, I can handle this, like I can take it, and then like I can lose for him, and then I can like we'll drink this little punishment that he made for me, and he just handles it. I like it how it shows their relationship, and it's so funny.
I completely agree with everything you're saying, because this is a fun episode, seeing like the evil side of Jake, but also like understanding Finn, how he knows how to deal with him, and I don't know if I should call it, like his Jake's bad points, but it's just really interesting to see this kind of... it's really cool and interesting to see their relationship in this way.
I mean, it's like every... everybody has their, like, you know, their negative traits, or maybe even something that they care a little too much about, and we're like, all right, you know, Ellen goes a little crazy over Adventure Time, like, she's a little weird, like, but you have, I just thought it was super cute.
No, it's a good one, definitely a good one. All right, you think you're ready for number uno?
I feel like it was obvious, but I'm so ready. Number one is I Remember You.
I Remember You.
I Remember You. And this one, so this one's not funny, I guess.
Not
like,
really.
No, I don't think I really laughed during it. This one just has so much depth and, like, emotion, and it has history, and it has relationships, and there's just, like, love and frustration and sadness and insanity. Like, I mean, I feel like a lot of people can relate to this. Like, if you've ever had a relative that you've lost to, like, dementia or Alzheimer's or something like that. Like,
Definitely.
This is such a, like, I don't know. And it hits me, and I cry every time. And, like, I also, like, even though I cry and it makes me sad, like, I also want to watch it.
No, you know, I don't want to spoil what's going on with my, you know, tops and bottoms, but, like, I completely agree with everything you're saying. This is, this is one of those episodes, like, it hits home hard. Understanding about, like, people, very specific people in your life. You know, you have this, you know, backstory, and it's not a bad one, it's not a good one, but it's, like, something, a part of you that you have to deal with.
Yeah.
Regardless of your relationship in the present.
And, like, how hard it is. Like, that Marceline... It's so funny. Okay, that was funny.
Okay, But, like, damn it. I didn't want to show that part, because it's... Okay, keep going.
But that, like, Marceline loves him. And she does want him around, but she doesn't want the Ice King around.
Yep.
She wants Simon back. Simon is lost to her. You know what I mean? So, like... But she still, like, you know, she knows she's still in there, so she, like, has to... She doesn't want to deal with him, but she has to because she still does love it. I don't know. That's so... That hits home on several levels.
It hit homes hard.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, this is a very good pick. I guess we're going to have similar tops.
Oh.
Yeah. Not to say it's bad, but it's, you know, that's just what it is.
Yeah.
Because they're great episodes. All right.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
I'm ready. I'm interested. Right.
So my top number three is Card Wars. Jesus Christ. Like, that's why I didn't say anything when you were talking. I fucking love this episode so much. This is such a fun episode. Seeing, like, the evil side of Jake, seeing Finn, like, try to deal with it in, like, the coolest way ever. I kind of had this history too when I used to play cards. Like, I used to play, like, Yu-Gi-Oh cards and Pokemon cards when I was younger in high school.
Were you Jake?
No, I wasn't. I was Finn. I was the one, like, trying to calm my friends down. But I think I was BMO. I think I was
I'm not playing with you anymore.
It was one of those things, like, I'll play with you, but once you become a dick, like, I'm out. And then I'll move on to my next friend. I don't know how else to explain it, but this was just, like, the idea of, like, my past and, like, how Jake is so obsessed, and it's awesome. It's so funny.
I love the flames in his face. Like, it's just so bad.
Yeah, it's so bad.
Oh.
Yeah, I love it. I love it so much. I actually wish they should have another, like, Card Wars 2, just them playing again. Like, they go... Like, I guess this is going to be spoiler, but, like, them doing, like, another tournament. And they have.
Yeah.
But it's just, like, the last ones is, like, Finn and Jake. You know?
Yeah.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
That'd be awesome to see. But, yeah, this episode was dope. I enjoyed it a lot.
It's a good one.
Yeah. All right. Top number two. I Remember You.
Oh!
That's why I didn't say anything as well when you were talking. Just, like, this episode was, like, it didn't hit home for me. But I understand why people would fall in love with this episode. Dealing with family members or just even a friend too, you know? Because we have those friends that are like our buds, like in, you know, in school, and then you become, you get older and you get back, and then, you know, there's still that history, you know, like just a friendship.
Yeah.
But they also played it for fun, like in this photo. I love this episode. It's so dear to my heart because it's that, and also they give you so much backstory, because I think everybody loves the story of the Ice King and Marceline.
Yeah.
Because their story goes along with what happens to what creates the Land of Ooh, right? Like, it just creates
right.
everything that we know in Adventure Time. So that's why this was something like that I would watch all the time.
Definitely. Yeah. The lore is cool. I think it's partially because they like only give you little bits and pieces,
mm-hmm.
which keeps like the mystery kind of alive.
Yep.
But I do. This is a good one. Good pick.
All right, top number one.
Mm.
And I think this kind of happened in our episode. We talked about this in our episode when I was having difficulty picking one or two.
Yeah.
And that is the Lich. Like I love this episode so much. This is kind of one of those episodes where, like, I think we get into, like, ending episode of the season
mm-hmm.
where, like, they just, like, you have no idea what the fuck is going on, and you get so intrigued. Like, you know what I'm talking about. Like, it's like it ends.
It's
where
like
you,
a cliffhanger.
Right. That's what I was trying to look for. But, like, a cliffhanger, like, a really good one where yeah. it's not a bad one. You're like, why would they do that? Like, no, it's a good to end. And wait, and you're very curious to know what's going to happen, because
yes.
man, it hit me so much, just not because like of the lore, but like, man, I love Billy is an awesome character, and the way he got fucked over makes sense in every
yeah.
way.
Yeah,
every it's, way and
it's like sad, it's super sad, but it's
yeah.
also like, I mean, he didn't, you know, he didn't go out, he went out in a way that, yeah, you're right, it makes sense
mm-hmm.
that Billy, like, when he's kind of old and not, you know, doing much,
it's not in his
the
prime.
Lich finally, like, comes, gets him.
Because I feel like Billy, in the past, has defeated the Lich. Like,
yeah,
I feel
that's
like he
the
has.
Story.
Right, and I love how the Enchiridion, like, goes together. I don't know how that book is so magic. You know, like, how that book can... like have the gems to like hold in the I don't or
do you I, remember
I don't
do you remember it's the Christmas episodes,
yeah, the Ice King's tapes and stuff like that,
yeah.
But
on the Ice King's tapes, when he goes and shows us the crown, he walks by a case that's holding the Enchiridion. So the Enchiridion is like older than whatever time, it's older than Marceline and Simon and stuff like that. So this actually, like, the Enchiridion is more than just this cute little book as we were introduced to it when Finn first gets it. It's another one of those things that is kind of a mystery and very cosmic. And yeah, I like how they did tie that in, because Billy is the person who gives Finn the Enchiridion.
Right. And it's just like a good flow of the story of the book and the gems and why there's so many princesses, especially this weird ass princess. like what the fuck, embryo princess? I just like no idea. But like, you know what I mean? Like, it's just a cool idea of just kind of meshing this random stuff together. And then ultimately, you know, the Lich kind of technically won at the end. You know, like, he defeated Billy. He opened the portal to something that we, at the time, we don't know. But, and, you know, Finn and Jake, like, this photo wants to stop. So,
yeah.
That's the reason why I like this a lot more than the other, than I Remember You.
I think I do like this as a season finale. But I usually, like, because it's a two-parter and you then have to go into season 5
mm-hmm.
to find out what happens, I think I get a little stressed by it because I'm like, oh, no. And then, like, even though I know what happens,
yeah.
I think that's why it's not in my tops. It's still, like, if I had to pick season finales, this is the season finale that had me going, what the fuck? Like, what just happened. So yeah. That's a good one. Yeah.
Yeah, and this episode makes me really want a sandwich.
It's super funny.
It's funny. It's fun. It's shocking. It's sad. It's super brave. You know, it's awesome. It's so dope.
It's cool.
I'm happy that I think this is probably so far my favorite ending episode of a season.
I agree. Yeah. I would say this is one of my favorite ending of these seasons. It's
1 through 4.
Yeah, of the seasons we've done so far, I think this is one of my favorite endings because it's like, it's such a perfect ending that it. I mean, it leaves you wanting more, but not in a sense where you're frustrated. I don't know. It's good.
I agree. And that's our tops and bottoms. Holy
tops and bottoms, guys.
Yeah, I really enjoyed these episodes. Not so much like my bottom two so much, but everything else, like out of the 26 episodes, right?
I believe so.
Yeah, they're awesome.
I really like season 4. I feel like I can open up season 4 and pick up any episode and be happy with watching it. There's just, I don't know. I wouldn't turn it down.
So, just to throw in the spoiler sign. Oh, the spoiler sign. Where are you? There we go. Just throw in the spoiler sign. Do you think season 5 is better than season 4?
Oh, God.
Mind you, season 5 is a shit ton of episodes.
It's a shit ton of episodes. Okay. I guess what I would say is this. I probably would pick more... I would say season 5 is maybe better, but if you took it as a whole, season 5 has more, and there are, like, I don't want to call it filler, because it's not filler, but there's more episodes where it's, like, you know, the King Worm, or, like, you know, just ones that are kind of, there's a lot of those, but there are also the ones that are really good and really interesting. I think season 4 is more, like,
tight.
So, I don't know. It's a hard choice.
As a prediction, because I do remember watching these episodes. Like, if I click on the episode, I'm like, oh, I remember this episode. But
yeah.
But just, like, reviewing as a whole for the season, it's going to give me a different perspective.
Yeah.
But I do remember vividly the beginning of season 5 and the ending of season 5, and I think that kind of like struck me more. And again, there's a lot more episodes, so yeah. We'll see.
That's hard to say. I think it's hard to compare those two, because I think in season 5, season 4 was where I felt that it was just like boom, every episode was really strong, and they knew what they were doing. But season 5 takes like a leap forward in a lot of ways,
and story and character. Yeah, exactly.
So that's gonna be interesting. We'll have to revisit this question.
Yep. We might have like a debate about which seasons we like.
We should each try and pick one, even if we like the same season, we should pick opposite seasons and like argue.
Sure. I can do that. We can do that. Yeah, this was a good episode. I enjoyed a lot of these episodes. It's going to be sad because this is kind of the introduction of characters like the Fire Princess. Fun things that I completely forgot about that were pretty good. And a good ending to the Lich and what he can do. Because that dude, I don't understand him. I don't understand evil. But man, he's just a destroyer of shit.
Yeah, I feel like he's more of a concept. And I'll go into why I think this. I feel like at the beginning of season 5.
Okay.
I feel like the Lich is more of a concept than an actual character.
Yeah, that makes sense. That definitely makes sense. But I think we're going to wrap this up.
Yeah, I think we're going to be finished.
Good. Yeah, definitely. But I think overall, for the things that are coming up soon for us, I think we're going to start season 5. But I kind of want to divide the episodes so that we don't have a hanging 2 or hanging 4 compared to everything else. So it'd be good maybe just to divide every episode that we do with, you know what I mean? Like,
we'll
I don't know.
Make a plan.
Right, we'll make a
plan.
Because
there's a lot more in season 5.
So we'll probably do like 4, maybe. Okay. Maybe 4 or 5, just so like we have a good even or a good amount of episodes to talk about at the end as well.
Yeah.
Because I think in our previous episodes, we kind of had like the last two episodes of the season, and then like Tops and Bottoms, and it's just like a really long episode.
Yeah.
So I'd rather just do a full
episode. We'll try and
divide
it up differently.
Yeah, definitely.
All right.
But yeah, this was fun. This was a lot of fun.
This was fun.
It's still nervous and wrecking to me because I was having a really difficult time trying to pick Tops and Bottoms. I mean,
I agree.
But at the same time, they were fun. There are a lot of fun episodes.
I think it's interesting to see how we thought of it. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
All right.
I think this is done. And I think for us, I think we'll be back next week with a certain amount of episodes. I don't know how many yet. Sorry to say.
It's a surprise.
Ooh, that's a good one. It's a surprise. But hopefully you guys are checking in. And if you ever want to talk to us about anything, about your mama's drawers, or you know, like, or your mom making curry because I like curry, or sandwiches, you know, you can email me at yes.fitS@gmail. If you want to talk to me personally and say something silly, I have Twitter, CDLR0R, and we have we have Twitch and we have the YouTube page, so it's all there. We all have a good back catalog. What about you?
You can reach out to me to talk about Adventure Time, beer, any worries that you're having. Just, you know, let it. I'm here. I'm a shoulder. You can talk to me. Find me on Twitter at Drinkin' Pretty. No G in the Drinkin' Pretty.
Nice. And I think we're definitely going to have a good time with season 5. I have positive ideas about it. But yeah, we'll be back, and hopefully we'll see you soon. Peace. Pancakes, that's what it's gonna make, bacon pancakes.